Beam me up, Scotty. Everyone knows the infamous line, although that exact wording of the phrase was never said on the show. Teleportation and Star Trek have become irrevocably linked in the public mind. Almost everyone wishes they could just teleport from one place to another and avoid the hassle of travel, so let's take a look at if it's possible. Star Trek's version of the teleporter uses things like an annular confinement beam and Heisenberg compensators. These things don't exist in our world, so we're going to have to find our own way. To achieve teleportation in the real world, we're going to have to deal with something many people run away from in fear, quantum mechanics. People like to think of quantum mechanics as the physics of the microscopic world. Using quantum physics, scientists have achieved a version of teleportation in the lab, quantum teleportation. The basic idea of quantum teleportation is that you aren't moving the actual particle. You're transferring the information or quantum state of the particle. Scientists believe at the most basic level, the elementary particles have the same basic properties as one another. So if I pick two random electrons, they should have the same mass. And if I pick two random protons, they should have the same mass. What distinguishes them is their quantum state. So if we somehow figured out how to teleport humans, we wouldn't be moving the actual particles, but more like the blueprint for your particles. One of the questions people like to ask is, are you more than just a bunch of quantum states? Do you have a soul? When I transfer the information from one group of particles to another, are you killing the original and then making a new person? These are the kind of philosophical questions teleportation brings up. You may also be thinking, can I use this quantum information to make multiple copies of myself? Nope, there's a thing in quantum mechanics called the no-cloning theorem. You can't make an identical copy of a physical state. I can't think of a way to explain it with a physical explanation, it's just the math. You do the math, mess around with experimentally verified equations, and you'll find it's impossible. You might also think, hey, it's just information. Why don't I just take a quick peek at the states and copy down the information? This is where quantum mechanics laughs at you and says, sorry, that's not going to work. By interacting with the states of the system, you've actually changed the states. There's debate to how that actually works, but the basic idea is that any, and I mean any, little peek changes the information or state of the system, and it's no longer the information you are trying to teleport. There's no way around this. Before we continue, we need to understand an interesting quantum quirk, quantum entanglement. Entanglement was actually proposed by Einstein and two colleagues, Podolsky and Rosen, as a thought experiment to show the absurdity of quantum mechanics. Through physical interaction, particles can become interconnected or entangled, so you can think of entangled particles as a single system. When one of these particles is measured, the other particle will have a measurement correlated to the value of the first measurement. This means when you interact with one particle, you are somehow affecting the other particle without any signal between them. Interestingly, this connection doesn't depend on distance. The two particles could be on opposite sides of the galaxy and remain entangled. The process of quantum teleportation relies on using an entangled pair of particles. The two entangled particles are then separated at two sites we'll call site A and site B. Measurements are done at site A on one of the entangled particles and on the particle you want to teleport. These measured values are then sent to site B through a classical channel, so something like a fiber optic cable or a signal to a satellite or a radio wave. Based on the measured values, the particle at site B can then be transformed into the teleported particle. That all sounds confusing, and at first look, it is. It's just something you have to look into more if you want to truly understand it. But the gist is that by using quantum entanglement and measurements, you can teleport the state of one particle to another. Now, some people might think this would allow for faster-than-light communication, but they'd be wrong. To get information out of the system, you still need to send a separate classical signal, like a radio message, in addition to the entanglement of the particles, and this signal is limited by the speed of light. Right now, we can teleport the state of things like atoms or a photon of light. Can we scale this up? A human body weighing about 150 pounds has about 7,000 trillion trillion atoms. Going from teleporting a couple of atoms to 7,000 trillion trillion atoms is quite a leap. First of all, the entanglement between particles is very fragile. Any little bit of interaction could break the entanglement, which is why many experiments have to occur in a vacuum protected from the environment. We are still very far away from figuring out a way to entangle large, complex systems. Right now, the goal for almost all research related to quantum teleportation isn't teleportation of people, but building quantum computers or securing communication with quantum cryptography. A quantum computer would allow us to simulate things like molecules better, so we can make new drugs and materials. A quantum computer would also allow us to do a bunch of other cool stuff, but I won't get into it. For now, teleportation is stuck in the lab, and only for very tiny and simple things. We're a long way off from being able to say, energize.